VR video tutorial on agent-based models, part two. So last time we talked about what an agent is, sort of. As we go along, you'll get a better feel for what these things are. Now, I'm going to use the code that I left off with last time, so just you're going to have to go back and watch the last video to get the code. But the goal here is for you to see how these things work. We've already defined our agents, and now what we want to do is we want to see how they move through time, but we're going to have to set up some parameters for them. Okay, and I want to do one other thing to my code. I want to make sure that my first person here is exposed so that I know in my population there is an exposed person because we're using the COVID-19 scenario. So when I rerun these, I will see that the first person will be exposed, and we'll talk about how to generate them where more and more people are exposed. But if I look at agent one here, you can see the first person is exposed and they have a high mixing probability, which means they're likely to go out and mix with other people. All right, now that I have this, now what I need to do is I need to move them through time. Okay, so this is, you know, however you want to consider this. This is their state now. I'm going to move them through time, and then I'm going to look and see if they meet with other people, what happens. So I'm going to need a parameter for each one of these, which I'll define along the way. But what I'm going to do essentially is I'm going to take each person or each agent. So I'm going to call them agent one. It comes out agent one. I'm going to take the ith person. Okay. And this is the information that I'm going to use for them. So I'm going to get information from them. So for this person, I want to see what their mixing parameter is. For example, I want to pull this off for agent I. Okay, this will allow me to grab their information, and I'm just going to call this mix one on purpose right now. And what I want to do is I want to use this to see how likely they are to interact with other people. So what I'm also going to do is I'm going to see here, let's just say they're going to randomly meet another agent. Okay, so this is going to take a little effort here. We're going to have this person meet another agent. Well, the first thing I need to do is determine how many other agents are they going to meet. How many agents will they meet? Well, in our case, we know that there's only 10 agents. Okay, so they're going to have a probability of meeting someone else, and maybe that's what this mixing parameter is, or we can use the mixing parameter to help determine how many people they will meet. So we're going to use that to determine how many people they will meet by taking and just simply multiplying the mixing parameter times the population, but we're going to change it. We're not going to go the whole population. I'm just going to say the mixing parameter times 3 here. And this will be, and then I'm going to round this one way or the other. So I'll round it to 0. I could use the ceiling or whatever. And what this does is it allows me to see how many people I'm going to meet. So determine whether they like to meet people or not. Others. Okay, so that's what this is going to tell me. And this is going to tell me how many people they're going to meet right now. We're going to change it and make it random. Then the next thing I need to do is grab the ones they will meet. Okay, so if we grab the agents they will meet, so let's see here. I want to do, what do I call this? Meet 2. This will be sample. We're going to sample from our list of agents from 1 to npop 1, and we're going to sample how many of them? Meet 1. Okay. And we're going to do replace equals true. So they could meet the same person over and over again, or they could meet lots of different people. So let's see what this does. So if I just run this here, and I'm going to change this to 1 first. So if I run this, this allows for, well, I look at mix one, I'll see it's a high number. Then I'll do meet one, and I'll see that they're going to meet 2 people. Then I look at meet 2, and they're going to meet individuals 4 and 5. Okay, that's what we're going to do, is we're going to have them meet individuals 4 and 5. Okay, so this is going to we're going to use this to determine whether or not they become exposed or not. So now that I know how many they have, I'm going to do a for loop because this is always going to change. It's not always going to be two. So I'm going to do one to the length, or J in one to the length of meet two. So I'm going to iterate through each of these people. So what I'm going to do is I am going to grab from my agents. So agent one, I'm going to grab my agent, which is meet two element J. Okay, so this is going to grab this agent for me, and then I can look at their properties. Okay, so this is going to be meet 1A. So they're going to meet one agent, and this is who they're going to meet. And then we're going to do something along the lines of if meet 1A equals dollar sign, and they're going to be an agent. Remember that if their status, which or state, is equal to E, then we are going to take a certain course of action. So they've been exposed. So what happens to my current agent? Well, then agent one, and we're playing with agent number one, his state will, for this person, agent I, which is one at the moment, we will make him exposed. Okay, and we're going to iterate through all of these. Okay, and then otherwise we don't change anything. So what we can do here is, okay, so first grab who they will meet. And then we can say, oh, if exposed, change state. And, of course, we're going to want to change this as well. Change state. Okay, so now let's make this in our outer loop. So for I in 1 to pop 1, or n pop 1, we'll take this, close it off down here. I'm trying to keep the code short and the video short here, which it's already running long, which I don't like. Okay, so this should work. I need to change this to agent I. Okay, so what does this do? If I run this, I'm going to go across each agent, and they're going to, wait, each agent, I forgot this I here, and it's going to see who they meet with, and it's going to have them meet with others, and then I can go back and look at agent one. And I see now, originally I started with one exposed. Now look, this person's exposed, this person's exposed, and this person is exposed. Okay, so this is a way for you to start modeling this. And we're going to play with how do you determine who they should better model with or not, and or not model with, who they should mix with or not. We should see if people who are unlikely to meet actually do that, and whether or not in the long run, those are the people who tend to not get the disease. But that's what we're playing with right now. But what I'm trying to get you to understand is each person is an agent, or each row here is going to be an agent. They have properties, and the properties will hopefully correspond to whether or not they would get this disease. All right, so we're going to pick up more on the next video where we make it slightly more complicated. So I'll see you there.